So good morning to everyone and welcome me all in the Young Leader Orison, Dr. Susila Nair, Young Leaders Orison. So I just for your knowledge that it is the third award. We had already two Orison session yesterday. The first session was awarded to Dr. Ravikant Singh and the session Young Leaders and second Young Leaders Award was awarded to Dr. Hemant Sevde. In this series, we have a third Dr. Susila Nair Young Leaders Orison today, and which is awarded to Dr. Venkatesh Siva Reddy. Before we go to the oration, I would like to welcome our chair and co-chair, Dr. Pradeep Deshmukh sir and Dr. Swati Mahajan ma'am. So I would like to introduce you all to the Pradeep Deshmukh sir. So Pradeep Deshmukh sir is currently working as professor in All India Institute of Medical Science, Nagpur. Sir has completed his MBBS and MD, and sir is also has certificate in international perspective in participatory monitoring and evaluation and postgraduate certificate in nutrition. Sir has areas of expertise in the qualitative research, epidemiology and biostatistics, reproductive and child health. Sir has many publications in the domain in various international and national journals. Sir has also published many chapters in various books. Sir has been also awarded as a prestigious award, Dr. D.K. Ramadwar Orison Award of Indian Association of Preventive and Social Medicine, Maharashtra chapter on 10th February 2019 at Nasik. I would also, I'm very happy to welcome you, sir. Sir was also a faculty at Mahatma Gandhi Institute of Medical Science for a long time. So sir, welcome you for this session. Then I would like to welcome our co-chair, Dr. Swati Mahajan ma'am. Dr. Swati Mahajan ma'am is currently working as a professor at Mahatma Gandhi Mission Institute and Hospital at Aurangabad. She has completed her MBBS and MD from Government Medical College, Aurangabad. Ma'am has also postgraduate diploma in clinical research. Ma'am has published various scientific papers in various national and international journals. Ma'am has a varied experience of the teaching as a professor in MGM Medical College. Ma'am, it is a privilege to have you today as a co-chair to conduct this session. So I would like to hand over this session to our chair and co-chair. Sir, over to you. Thank you. Sir, you are muted. Sir, you need to unmute your mic first.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible, sir.
Hello. At the outset, let me thank IIPSM and organizers at MGIMS for making me part of this very important activity, Nurturing Champions for Public Health Agenda. The Dr. Susila Nair Young Public Health Leader Oration 3 has been awarded to Dr. Venkatesh Siva Reddy B. Let me read the citation. Dr. Susila Nair was an Indian physician and veteran Gandhian. She played a leading role in several programs for public health, medical education, and social and rural reconstruction in our country. She was born on December 26, 1914 in Kunja, a small town in Gujarat district of Punjab, now in Pakistan. Her life was not a fairy tale, but rather an astounding saga of sacrifices and accomplishments. She completed her MBBS and MD from Lady Harding Medical College, Delhi. And then she moved to, her participation in freedom struggle, she went to John Hopkins School of Public Health to pursue her master's in public health and doctor of public health. She returned back in 1950 and served as first health minister of Delhi from 52 to 55. She started many fundamental health programs against diseases like malaria, venereal diseases, tuberculosis, and leprosy. From 62 to 67, she served as Union Health Minister. During this period, she established few medical colleges in the country, including Mahatma Gandhi Institute of Medical Sciences in 1969, the Gandhi birth centenary year, and remained committed to confine her energies to developing and extending it. Her vibrant dynamism evoked awe and exuberance. Though a stickler of discipline, she was a lovable and affectionate person. It included a lasting respect in minds of those who had a good fortune of sharing her company, and I was lucky to be with her and listened her Friday sermons for years or more than decade period. She was affectionately known as Badi Behenji. Dr. Suchila Nair died at the age of 86 in the year 2001. She has been very appropriately hailed as the leading light in the discipline of community medicine in our country, and was also honored as the Public Health Person of Millennium Award in 2000. And therefore, this oration is conferred on the budding young health leader, Dr. Venkat Shiva Reddy B, in her fond memory, to inspire many young professionals to emulate her in making a difference to the public health and society at large. A few words about Dr. Venkat Shiva Reddy B. He did his MD in community medicine from AIIMS New Delhi and is currently working as associate professor at NRI Medical Academy of Medical College and General Hospital, Guntur, Andhra Pradesh. He has been very active in academics and is also an innovator. He innovated Matru Samman Pant, which deserves a special mention. On behalf of the organizers and IIPSM, I bestow this award on Dr. Venkat Shiva Reddy and invite him to deliver his oration. Dr. Venkat Shiva Reddy, please.
Thank you, Dr. Deshmukh sir. It's an indeed my sincere thanks to the organizing team of IIPSM Young Leaders Conclave 2021, organized by MJMS Sevagram. Am I audible?
Yes, please go ahead.
Yes. So now I would like to thank all the organizing team and all the faculty members who are involved in this great event. So are promoting and encouraging all the young public health personnels. So now I have started my career 5 or 6 years back after my MD. So we are in the academics and also doing some small researches and some small innovations. So here I'm going to show one of my small innovation. So the idea came when we are doing MD at AIIMS New Delhi. So we thought of starting this at AIIMS Delhi only, but due to some reasons we could not do it. But later on I started working as a state maternal health consultant for UNICEF for the state of Andhra Pradesh. So there I got the opportunity to show my small innovation. So this innovation got some recognition, and later on we proposed in a program implementation plan for Andhra Pradesh. So we got sanctioned for this. So now Andhra is going to start this innovation for the entire state, so in due course of time. So now I'm sharing my presentation. So the name which I have given for this innovation is Matru Samman Pant. So it's an initiative towards respectable maternity care at public health hospital or institutions. Okay. So I will go through this innovation in next few minutes of around 15 to 20 minutes. So how we started and how we proceeded from idea to implementation. So we used to think when we are attending labor room postings and we are conducting deliveries, especially when we are posted at secondary level hospitals and rural health hospitals, so under the field practice area of IIMS New Delhi. So when we usually enter the labor room, especially as a male junior residents, so many of the pregnant women who are on the labor table, so they used to feel very uncomfortable. And we used to see this, and that time few of our colleagues were doing MD, so especially the female colleagues, they used to say, so we could do something for these females, because our labor rooms are having AC facility, and all the our Indian ladies usually wear the petticoat and sari. So when we do PV examination and when the active stage of labor, so they have to be exposed to epigastrium. So when suddenly someone enters, especially the whether it is male or female, suddenly they used to feel uncomfortable. They used to close their legs and they used to look that side, this side, and all. So that time we got the idea. So like we have OT pants or OT dress. For the same pant, why can't we make some vulval opening with some dress so that can be worn by pregnant women? So when we are not using, not doing any procedure, when you are not delivering, so that time she will be covered from waist to ankles. So she will feel very comfortable. So that was the idea. So then that time, so we visited some places also. Especially the tailors, we want this kind of dress, can you stitch? So we could not get it. So we thought how to start. Then I explained this concept to many people. So everyone was very positive. So later on, actually I searched on the internet and some other research articles where we have this kind of this thing. So then I came to know that some countries where some religions are majority, for example, in Malaysia, so they have Muslims as majority populations. They wanted to minimize the overexposure, especially during childbirth also, because of their religious beliefs. And they have some this kind of pants. So it is commercially available. It is called Mama Pride. The name of Mama Pride, it is available. So later on, I thought that it will not be successful in India. So we need to find something that can be suitable that looks like Indian dress. So dress, but that should be suited for our Indian hospitals. So then I thought, why we are not using this kind of dresses, especially in our public healthcare facilities, when we have so much funds in RM and SES plus year program and all. So common reasons were high cost if we tell them to buy, and we have many cases coming for a hospital, and most of these families are not demanding, the clients are not demanding, they are comfortable with their own dresses. So now, as many tailors also I have already told, they told that if you bring some prototype, then only we can stitch as such, we cannot stitch like this. So I visited many tailors. So this is the concept, and they used to be impressed, even tailors also, but they could not stitch me. I visited nearly 10 or 15 tailors. So later on, I asked my mother-in-law, she was doing a little bit stitching. So I asked her, so I'm thinking of this kind of idea to give it for pregnant women, especially when they're labor. So I wanted to stitch a dress. So she helped me to prepare a prototype of Matru Samman pant. So later on, when I was working as a state consultant for maternal health for UNICEF, so that time I was with implementing Lakshya in our Andhra Pradesh, especially to improve labor room procedures or labor room qualities. So that time we have the same principles. Here we need to respect the privacy of the pregnant women, their choices and their freedom. And they are supposed to be free from any ill treatment or discrimination. So that time I thought, I think we can introduce this pant also. under this labor room quality improvement initiative, so that here the pregnant woman, the client, can get a good satisfaction, especially avoiding the shy free environment, and the same time she will feel very confident to give birth to her baby. Okay, so this was the concept I presented it at the UNICEF head office Hyderabad in 2018. So that time many of our consultants and our seniors, so they got impressed. They say that if you show like this and we can give funds also, we can implement it also, but that will be one for some centers. So then one of our senior, Dr. Sanjeev Upadhyay, he is in UNICEF now, he suggested that, so if we can convince our bureaucrats, so that time Dr. Poonam Malpandey was the special chief secretary for health. So he told that if you, this concept is very nice, please go and show it to her once. If she agrees, so that will be the breakthrough for Andhra Pradesh. So we can implement in entire government health facilities in Andhra Pradesh. So later on, I prepared presentations, I prepared many mails and photo galleries, and I tried to meet that madam. So around 5 to 6 times I went there. Time, so I went with the director of public health and additional directors of maternal health and joint directors. So she gave me 5 minutes time. So I presented this concept with the prototype. So she was right away, she said that this is very good concept, so use right away. If you have some trial testing and all, so you can go ahead with, and we can propose it for government of India, especially under NHM. So that time, so we already did a trial of this, because that vulval opening which that plant is having, so that has to be revised many times. So if you make it small, we cannot do procedures, and we cannot do many procedures like episiotomy or stitching of episiotomy, or if sometimes we may need to apply forceps. So these kind of procedures we could not be able to do. So that way we revised that vulval opening many times. And finally, we did a trial at one of the district hospital in Visakhapatnam district. So that time, so it was successful, because there was no limitations for doing procedures, either pervasion examinations or procedures or delivery of the baby or placenta. So we were confident, so this opening is enough, this dress is comfortable pregnant women, and the nurses and the doctors and the gynecologists, everyone felt very happy. So with this successful trial, so then after approval from the special chief secretary that time, Dr. Poonam Malapandaya, so we proposed for government of Andhra Pradesh under NHM. Okay, before going to that procedure, I want to explain what is the actually this dress. So it is looks like almost our operation theater dress, like scrub dress, operation theater pant. So it has some special features like vulval opening, I already mentioned. So only the vulva area will be exposed, the remaining will be covered. Okay, so that opening is very good enough to do procedures like pervasal examination or episiotomy or forceps application or Ventu application. Sometimes we need to bladder catheterization, and delivery of the baby and placenta is the primary objective. Okay. And if you make only opening, so the woman may not be achieve that safe free environment. So then we prepared flaps on the front and back side. So if that pregnant woman wears this, so as if she is wearing some Indian churidar dress. So it looks like pajama and kurta. Okay. So when she is walking, when she is sleeping, so that vulval opening will be covered. Okay. So this was the special feature of our Indian dress. So what are the uses we expected from this pant is, so one is, so it can be component for respectable maternity care. So privacy for the pregnant women, because nowadays when you are having high case loads in one single labor room only, we have more than 2 or 3 or 4 labor tables on which already the patients are waiting. Okay, and their attenders and the attending nurses and the doctors. So overcrowding, so they feel very uncomfortable. So that's why if we use this pant, So when they are not doing any procedures, they will be covered. They will be just lying down as if they are lying on their bed. Okay. And one more thing. So when you want to do some procedure, suppose pervasion examination, usually we do every 4 hours, it is normally progressing. But sometimes we don't stick to these timelines. Sometimes one JR comes, sometimes the SR comes, sometimes the nurse comes. So every time they will see. So what is the progress of labor, especially the dilatation of cervix? Okay. So when they do this procedure, if the pregnant woman is wearing sari and petticoat, so she has to lose her petticoat and she has to expose herself. So once they do procedures, she has to get ready also once again. So there was some time consumption during this preparation phase also. So if you use this band, they don't have to do this dress or undress part. Just lift the flap and do the procedure. And once you finish the procedure, just cover with the flap. Okay, just 1 minute or one few seconds away. One more thing, now almost all of our labor rooms are having autoclaves now, just to give sterile dresses. So this dress can be sterilized and it can be reused. Okay, so when we are autoclaving it, I think indirectly we can prevent infections that are spreading from unhygienic dresses which they wore from houses. Next, now under this labor quality improvement initiatives like Lakshya and all, so every labor room is provided with ACs now. So ACs, usually our staff members keep around 16 to 22. So it will usually be very cold if you expose our body parts. So if they wear this kind of dress or pant, it will be covered till ankle. So they may be comfortable for the patient, especially to prevent cold exposure. So indirectly, it will increase the satisfaction. It will give good confidence. So it may increase institutional deliveries. Once they get good confidence, they are taking care of us, especially with respect to privacy also. So the institutional delivery may increase. So it may have some impact on maternal MMR and IMR. So implementation is very much feasible, we have already told, easily washable and autoclavable and reused. So we are having facility for this. And how we planned is, suppose one PHC or CHC, if they are conducting around 10 deliveries per day, so we expected 1:3 ratio, one delivery, three dresses. So weight is three, so one will be in use for today, so one will be in the process of washing or autoclaving, and another set is for reserve, suppose of untoward climatic conditions. Okay, so we propose like this. So if we dress stitched, if we use it for 10 to 20 times, the cost of this dress per delivery cost comes around 15 rupees to 20 rupees. So that is very much affordable. So now the government is providing all consumables free under NSSK or JSSK too. So this cost is not too much and the benefits are very high. And this dress can be worn by pregnant women without any special help. They are wearing sari and all, they need help because they cannot bend, they are in labor pains. But this band doesn't require special help. This is how the dress looks like, some images I'm showing here. So when the patient is lying on labor table, so we can see this is the pant like thing. And this is the flap, the front flap. So it can be lifted. Once you lift it, the vulval opening looks like this. So this is the dummy baby head I'm showing here. So once you lift the flap backwards, so the vulval opening will be looking like this. Suppose the patient stands like this, so you can see the flaps are covered from front side and as well as from the back side, front and back side. So it almost looks like Indian pajama kurta if someone is wearing. So pregnant nowadays we are recommending pregnant women to walk around, so you can sit, she can opt for any kind of position for normal delivery. Okay, so this dress is very much useful. Okay. So this is how the dress looks like. So when we proposed for Andhra state under NHM through program implementation plan, so we got approved for 1 crore 40 lakhs to be implemented by Andhra government for government health facilities only for normal deliveries. Okay, So this is one recognition and it can be implemented state wise. So because of COVID last year, they were supposed to implement, because of COVID situation, they could not implement. Maybe in due course of time, we could see in our government health facilities and place we may, when someone visits. So when someone is going undergoing delivery, you can see someone wearing this kind of dress. So that's one kind of self-satisfaction we get. So how we are future directions. So this is a small thinking we had during our postgraduate. Implement, we are planning to implement at state level. So this will be the some kind of, if you are in some clinical exposure, we can identify the problems and the same thing can be corrected if you have correct directors or correct mentors and with our supporting staff. And one thing is, we are supposed to be continuously following up of your idea to implement. So if somewhere if you relax, that will get stalled. So I would like to thank all of these members, like Dr. Poona Malapandaya, Dr. Aruna Kumari, the Director of Public Health and Family Welfare Andhra, and the Commissioner of EPVP, and the Joint Director Dr. Jayashree, and my seniors, Dr. Sanjeev Upadhyay, Dr. Meena Som at UNSF Hyderabad when I was working there. And the idea which I got, I would like to thank the CRHS people of God, where we used to conduct deliveries during our busy times. At least on average 5 to 20 deliveries we used to see in our centers, and one of my colleague Dr. Preeti Gupta was the one she wanted to address this problem. So I would like to thank all of this. Next, I would like special thanks to Meera Gupta ji, because she is the one who prepared the prototype. Without this prototype, I could have not presented anywhere. Okay, so these are the acknowledgements which I want to show. So here now I'm in academics. So usually I will share all of my some thinkings to with my students. So when you are in medical college, so we get so many helping hands if you want to do anything, and the students are there for 1 to 3 years, and they will be coming back in the internship also. So if you really want to test something, so we can do it. Okay, so this is a small example how I started with some idea, then how I followed it up with government health facilities, and I presented somewhere in how it get incorporated in NHM. So maybe in some next time when they are assessing some innovations, so if it gets successful from Andhra Pradesh, maybe we can scale up to other states also. Okay, with this I conclude. Thank you very much for all the organizers of this IAPSM Young Public Health Leaders Conclave. Now I would request any questions if you have. Then I can hand out to our coaches, Dr. Pradeep Deshmukh sir and Mahajan ma'am, Swati Mahajan.
So thank you, Dr. Venkatesa, for sharing your innovation. We all have been through the labor room, and we all have felt bad that the any patient has to expose their private parts. We know this is the compromising situation for the any patient. It is compromising with their dignity, which is their right. But we all have felt, and you proactively acted on that, and this is the quality of leader, and you truly deserve the public health Dr. Sushila Nair Memorial Young Leaders Oration. And thank you very much for the session. I would like to have a opening remarks from the our co-chair ma'am, Dr. Swati Mahajan ma'am, please. Okay, so I would like to request Pradeep sir for comments.
Thank you, Dr. Venkat Shiva Reddy, for sharing such a important innovation, and you rightly described how it is important and how it will have impact in terms of reduction in maternal mortality, infant mortality. Dr. Mahajan has is there. I will request her to take it further. Dr. Swati ma'am. Unmute, unmute. Unmute yourself, madam.
You will need to unmute yourself.
Now you will be able to unmute yourself.
Hello?
Hello? Yeah.
You are audible, ma'am.
Yeah, am I audible now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So thank you very much. First of all, I'd like to thank organizers for making me co-chair for this wonderful, really wonderful oration. I'm really so much impressed. Like, I don't have words to say for the topic which has been addressed, really, that has been since long that we are facing. Like, even my during my undergraduate days, I have myself observed this problem, and I am really very happy that the way Dr. Reddy has a vision, and he has made that innovation, which is like a woman can maintain her dignity. It's a really, really wonderful oration. Last year, Dr. Sanjay Zotpe sir, our national president, he came up with this idea of a young leaders national conclave. So I really congratulate and thank sir for giving this platform to our young leaders, because otherwise we will not be aware of such great talents that our young leaders are having. Dr. Reddy has really shown not just the innovation, but the leadership qualities to implement and accept this as a policy in Andhra Pradesh. And I'm sure this is going to be there at a national level. So really, really wonderful oration by Dr. Reddy. So I would request Dr. Deshmukh sir to have concluding remarks.
Thank you, madam. This is like a demonstration how a small idea with huge impact can be worked out, and certainly we all will take a lead and how small problems can be addressed, and we can innovate in such manner. Thank you, Dr. Venkatesh Shiva. Thank you, organizers. Over to you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your comments. Now I would like to request to ask any question to Dr. Reddy. If you have any question or any comments, so you can unmute your mic and you can speak, or you can write in a chat box, please.
Hello, sir. It was a really enlightening speech. I'm Dr. Mandar Bhaviskar. I would like to just ask you, the innovation scaling up that you are planning to do, are you planning it as a social enterprise or as a public enterprise, or anything like that? Has any decision been taken regarding that?
Can I answer this question, sir?
Please.
Sir, when we came up with this idea, many of my friends and colleagues, they suggested me go for patent. So I thought of getting patent for this dress, but finally I thought that now I'm very at young stage to go for all these patents and these procedures. What I will do is, first I will start implementing in government health facilities, and I will give my idea to government health one, and I will not take any credit. Only I have published this concept on one of the journal. I have designed this place and now it has been planning to implement in Andhra Pradesh. Once it gets trained, it will can be implemented anyway. So I don't have any special claims or patents for this. So it, anyone can copy this and they can start doing. So for me is implementing anywhere is the best option, best satisfaction which I get.
Thank you, Dr. Manda, for really, your question.
That's really great on the part of Dr. Reddy. And at this age, he is doing this. I'm really, really very impressed. And the name that has he has given, Matru Samman, it's so apt. So everyone will remember you whenever this dress is being used, definitely.
Yes, thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Do we have any another comment or questions from the participants? You can unmute your mic.
Hello, Dr. Reddy.
Hello.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Dr. Reddy, nice and very beautiful presentation and innovation. Congratulations to you and the whole team. You make us all very much proud as a you are like an inspiration to all of us. Thank you very much for that, sir. IIPSM young session for all of us.
Thank you, sir.
Copyright. Go forward and patent thing, because once you patent, one will be applying for a patent for the same, sir. You go for a copyright and a patent, and then it is your decision to make it open use for all, for government and but you should
yes sir, that was the initial suggestions from many, but I do not wanted to involve those formalities of patenting and all. So one thing is to say that this is my concept. It came some years back, so I published this concept in the journal. So later on, I think I can quote somewhere. That is the only thing I have.
Okay. Okay, sir. Still, think on the same idea, sir. You can go. Let's try, sir. Yes. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
That's all, sir. That's all from me.
Do we have any more comment or questions? Dr. Reddy, I just want to ask you first thing. I mean, congratulations to you. It was really such an inspiring talk. I just want to ask that what was the reaction from the patients? Can you describe one reactions, how they reacted to this after having these pens in the labor room?
Yes, sir. So when actually we tested or trialed this pant in one of the district hospital, so I asked all the members, starting from the patient's attender and the patient or a pregnant woman herself and the staff nurse and their supervisor and gynecologist and everyone. Straight away, I got like success. Sir, we are very happy if this kind of dress is available. All of our ladies, especially that district hospital was covering for tribal population. So in that area, the tribal population, usually they don't go to hospital because the doctors or the nurses, usually they use some foul language and they don't respect privacy. And especially they will expose everyone in front of even males also. So the one of the patient was from that belt area only. She felt very happy. Sir, I never expected I will get this kind of honor, even though it is your testing when I took consent for trialing also. She said that I am very happy that I got this opportunity. So this was her reaction. So now I can be happily, I can sleep for next 2 hours. No problem. It was her reaction, sir.
It's really wonderful. So I am not seeing any question in the chat box. That was lots of appreciation for you, Dr. Reddy, in the chat box. You can also read that. Abhishek, sir, do you want to add something here?
Nothing. I think his work is inspirational. And to me, it's a lesson on how whatever small innovation we may have, not giving up on that, on working on that. And I think it will be like what our chair and co-chair said, it would be inspirational for everybody. Personally, I thank Deshmukh sir and Swati ma'am to join here. And I think they could have been the best possible chair and co-chair for this particular oration. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am.
The last comment I would like to make. So for as a person from community medicine, we all are like at least most of us always feel that we are not concerned with the whatever is happening on the clinical side. But he has proven that yes, if you are observant anywhere, whether it's in the clinical setting or in the community, definitely you can come up with such innovative ideas. So all the other young people, they should learn, or they can have inspiration from him and come up with such very good ideas. Thank you. Thanks
yes.
a lot.
Yes, ma'am, for this compliment, I'll add one point. So when we are doing PG, madam, that time we used to do night duties and this labor room duties also. So few of our batchmates used to ask, we're not going to become clinicians in future. Why we are given this kind of clinical exposure, seeing 100, 120 patients in 2 hours per resident and conducting 20 laboratories every day. So that time one of our professor, he told that, once you know the ground reality of patient problems, so then only you can become good policy maker in near future.
Yes.
So that was that their words actually. So we used to think only night duty, day duty off, and night time they are knocking out doors, so the patient has come, delivery has come, complications, referral and all. So this was the answer we got from our professors. If you know the ground realities of all patient problems, then you can address the quality of the quality improvement initiatives.
That's very true. Like sitting under the fan or AC, one cannot become a good epidemiologist. That is really true.
Yes, ma'am.
So if we do not, yes, sir. So sir, can we conclude this session?
If Deshmukh sir has to add something.
Yes, sir. Deshmukh sir.
No, please close it.
Okay, thank you, sir.
You can close the
thank you, everyone. Right? Okay, thank you, everyone, for joining. Thank you, Dr. Reddy. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you. We have a next session on the Beyond the Beaten Path, so you can also join that. We have a panelist there. So, thank you, everyone.
Thank you, everyone. Bye.